Yo, what's up, guys? So this week, besides enhancing, we were working on the ring upgrades. So basically, we were grinding the LVO grind spots. And we have been grinding quite a lot. Do you guys remember how I was wondering if I should push level 64? Well, no need to wonder anymore. We already reached 45% this Sunday, so we are grinding quite a lot. But also, you know, all these XP bonus events are amazing. Grinding currently with 2500% XP bonus. XP is just flying at early spots. But as I said, working on that crit ring upgrade. The reason why I'm going for the crit damage is, well, for PV, for more damage. So here we are, managed to get one crit upgrade so far. Put it in the Omnius ring and already have 68 of the shards for the next one. So we're quite close of getting the second one also. Definitely gonna get that next week. And talking about the upgrades, I did change my current gear. I sold one of my pen accessories. I sold my pen Narc and swapped it to the Tet distortion. There are a couple reasons why I did that. One of the reasons why I did this swap is because of that 1 IP and 1 DP bonus that everyone got this week. So I don't need Narcs to reach the 401 bracket. Even with the 2 Tet distortions, I'm able to reach 401 DP bracket, and that was like one of the reasons why I wanted to keep the Narc still. I didn't want to go below 401 DP bracket. And another reason is that we are not grinding anymore only Kama Sylvia or Delita mobs. So having that Kama Sylvia monster damage is not that relevant anymore, because LVA is just normal mobs, so they don't work on them. And it's better to have a bit more AP on the LVA spots, especially because I'm missing my Pen Blackstar, so my Awakening AP is still around 301, 300... It was 301, yeah, with Narcs. And with the distortions, we reached the 305 IP bracket. So those were the reasons why I decided to swap finally from Narc to distortions. And well, to be honest, I never had Narcs in my final build. Currently for my first iteration of the build, I'm looking for Pen Distortion, Pen Dawn, and Pen Turos. 3 Pen Accessories, 2 Weight, and of course Pen Blackstar. So in total we need to make 4 items, we need to succeed enhance 4 items, and of course we'll be trying to reach that. Also, do you guys remember 2 weeks ago I said that I'll be investing money into some items? Part of money was invested into memory fragments. But most of the money was invested into an item that will be blowing up on the upcoming stream. More information about the stream will be at the end of the video. And on this, let's get into enhancing. Maybe one day the RNG will be on your side. the slack today for me, because we are getting back to back Ted Barker. Hold it, I'm off. Alright, time to fail, boys and girls. Five fails, fail, okay, first fail succeeded, second fail, good, third fail, only three fails left. And it went. Failed, guys. Failed. Unlucky. As always, when you don't need to succeed, it succeeds. Smash mode ban. Next smash mode ban. Let's go. Two pass. Come on. Third attempt. Setbacks. A bit of lingering. Okay, last one. Seems like today, no more second plan. Yeah. No plan below 200. So yeah, we got quite lucky with enhancing, managed to make two dead bastards and one pen boss armor, liquidated a lot of money, we'll be using that money of course for more enhancing. Well, if you guys were wondering what I invested with Tibulan into, no need to wonder anymore. We have bought 36 resplendent alchemy stones. And we are blowing up them today. The stream is today, right after this video is over. Head out to my Twitch channel at twitch.tv/BarokHan and let's see what we will get. But if you missed the stream, don't worry, I'll be uploading the recap as usual next week. So don't forget to subscribe to not miss that video, and if you enjoyed the content, please give a like, and see you guys on the stream. Bye bye.